is working against your destiny. Today, by the fire of this altar, I command it to disappear in the name of Jesus. You will not drive me the way your help has in the name of Jesus.
Hello viewers, this is Kingdom Voice. My name is Pastor Jide Ogunsakin, the Senior Pastor of New Kingdom Church. You are about to watch a life-transforming, a life-changing message from Kingdom Voice. As you listen and watch, be blessed. Your life will never remain the same again. God bless you.
Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we exalt your name. We magnify your name, Lord. We celebrate your faithfulness. We worship you, Lord. We give you praise. Thank you, Jesus. Blessed be your name, Lord. In Jesus' wonderful name, we are praying. Amen. Let us pray for Nigeria. Father, where we are right now, move us forward from there. The grace to move forward. The grace to be at peace in this nation. Lord, release it upon us today in the name of Jesus. Pray that prayer right now for Nigeria. The grace to move forward from where we are peacefully, peaceful coexistence as one nation. We bind the spirit of division in this nation. We bind the spirit of rioting. We bind the spirit of activities of demons and devils, satanic activities. We bind it in this nation in the name of Jesus. We release the spirit of God. We command the presence of God upon this nation for peace in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' precious name, as a church, we decree peace concerning this nation. As a church, we release grace for this nation to move forward from where we are right now. In the name of Jesus, we rebuke the spirit of demons and activities of Satan. In this nation, in the name of Jesus, we resist Satan. We resist demons. We resist activities that is capable of bringing calamity and political imbroglio in this country. In the name of Jesus, we decree political stability. We decree economic stability. We decree stability in all facets of life in this nation. In the name of Jesus, whatsoever God has destined Nigeria to be, I speak as God's prophet, and I declare that so shall it be concerning this nation. The will of the enemy will not be established in this nation. In the name of Jesus, whoever will sit on the throne of president in this nation, we possess that person with the spirit of God. Is not permitted to do his will. Only God's will is permitted to be done. And let the name of the Lord alone shall to be glorified. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Just wave your hands unto Jesus and celebrate him. Nigeria is peaceful, no problem. Hallelujah. I didn't see any calamity. I didn't see any trouble. Whatsoever any prophet has spoken about calamity, by this operation of this altar that I'm standing, those end time prophet, those calamity will not come to pass. In the name of Jesus, if I be a prophet of God, this country will be peaceful. Whoever need to will be installed as a president will be installed. At the name of the Lord, the Lord shall be glorified. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's celebrate Jesus for this country. Hallelujah. Praise God. Awesome God. A great God. Can the church put their hands together for the pastorate of New Kingdom Church? Come on, celebrate them. Wow. Wow, wow. The pastors have been doing wonderful works. I was hearing all the good works that the pastor of the church has been doing. And I want to say that I love you all. And God will continue to increase the pastors in Jesus' precious name. Now celebrate yourself. Celebrate yourself. When you are celebrating yourself, you do it like this. I'm celebrating me. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Then my wife is calling in the house this morning. Can you celebrate her for me? Come on, come on. You can do better than that. Come on. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. By the time we celebrate her better, she will pack all her packages and baggages from Kaduna and come to Abuja. Come on, celebrate her better so that she can come. Because you don't grow where there is no acceptance. You only grow where there is acceptance. There is no will when there is no acceptance. There is only will when there is acceptance. Amen. So let your cloud show you that you accept her to return. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm just glad to be back from U.S. and wonderful works that God has done over there. For those of you that are on Facebook, you will see some of the tips of the things that God had done in the United States. And we are at the verge of getting a property as well. And everything is just working together for our good. You know, everything just working together for our good. Everything just working together for our good. Amen. So let's celebrate God for what he's doing on behalf of New Kingdom Church. We are moving forward and the gate of hell will not prevail. In the name of Jesus, we are moving forward and the gate of hell shall not prevail. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. Today, I'm going to be ministering to us according to the leading of the Holy Spirit, something I titled, Turning Rejection into Blessing. Part 1. I'm going to do part 2 on Thursday. Turning Rejection into Blessings. Turning Rejection into Blessings. Nobody in life is immune against rejection. Nobody. Anybody can be rejected at any level. No matter the height that you have attained in life, you can be rejected in a certain area of your life. There is nothing like I've grown beyond rejection. As long as you live and the breath of life is in you, you are likely to be rejected at one time or the other. What is rejection? Number one, rejection simply means saying no to you. If you desire something from someone and you make your request known to the person or to a group of persons or to an organization or an application somewhere and they simply say no to you, you have just been rejected. Amen. Or they said, I'm sorry, like the embassy language. Embassy language is, I'm sorry. When you just hear, I'm sorry, you are a rejected person. Praise God. When you are going to the embassy, you don't want to be rejected. The simple language of prayer you need to pray is that, Lord, I reject the language of I'm sorry. Because immediately they say, I'm sorry to you, you have been rejected. You will not be rejected. It equally means refuser. It means refuser. When you are refused of something, you have just been rejected of that thing. I'm just going to create a very good foundation today and we'll build on it probably part 1, part 2, part 3. Amen. Because this is a topic that is very important. I was at the airport in Heathrow and the Lord spoke to me, son, on Sunday, I will ask you to teach on, turning rejection into blessings. I don't know for whatever reason. Amen. But as good or as bad as rejection looks like, everybody that will be successful in life or that will experience breakthrough in life must graduate from the school of rejection. Life has a school called the school of rejection. Unless you graduate from the school of rejection, you cannot experience absolute success in life. So in other words, whether in the biblical days or in our days today, all the people that are successful, there is one major thing that is common about them. They have been rejected at one time or the other. What is rejection? Rejection simply means denial or dismissal. It means denial. When you are denied of something, or something about you is being dismissed, you have just been rejected. Amen. Praise God. Everyone suffers rejection. We all experience one turn of rejection or the other, at one time or the other. Some of the greatest successful people in the world today have enjoyed or have suffered rejection in one area or the other of their lives. Now, let's look at the biblical injunction of rejection. Three major characters. There are almost all the successful characters in the Bible. I can bring out scriptures of rejections about them. Now, but I'm going to examine only three of them because of time, and this is part one. Number one, Jesus, the greatest man that ever lived, was rejected by his own people. He was rejected by the Jews. As a matter of fact, he was rejected by the Jews, and his message was not accepted by the Jews. Even though Jesus was a son of God, and Jesus was a main player in the restoration of humanity on earth, even though he was God personified himself, yet people of Jesus rejected him. Hello? Hello? Praise God. I want you to follow me with keen interest. Just follow me because I'm going somewhere. Jesus, the greatest man that ever lived. Because if I want to talk about God, yeah, because God himself was rejected. If I have to start from God, but I want to start from someone who had lived like a man on earth, so that you won't say, okay, God is God. Nobody sees him. So anybody can decide to reject him because people cannot see him. Of course, it is in the nature of a man to reject somebody when he's not seen. Amen. So God himself was rejected. Until tomorrow, they are still rejecting God. And they will continue to reject God until Jesus. So your own case of rejection is not a big deal. It's not new. Don't kill yourself because of rejection. A lot of people have committed suicide because they have been rejected in one way or the other. Amen. So Jesus was rejected by his own people. He was rejected by the Jews. They refused his message. He was preaching to them and they didn't accept his message, even though he was the Messiah. His own people. Now Jesus had to go and preach to the people that were not his own people, and those were the people that received the Jesus. That's why the Bible says in the book of Romans, it says, as many that receive him, they have become the sons of God. As many that receive. So it's not everybody that will receive him. But as many that receive him. So it doesn't matter whether you are a Jew. If you don't receive him, you are not a son of God. Number two, Paul the apostle apostle was the greatest apostle that ever lived. I don't know anybody who has preached the gospel of Jesus more than Paul. I don't know. I don't know anybody who had a deep revelation of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ like Paul. Nobody. He was the greatest apostle that ever lived. But yet, the Jews who are his own people, they rejected him. They won't listen to his message. They won't obey him. That's why I know, even if you are called into ministry and you find it difficult to even raise 10 people as your member, it doesn't mean that you're a failure. Some people may reject you, they may reject your message, it doesn't matter. That doesn't mean that your message is not acceptable by God. Just stick to what God has sent you to do. Amen. You know, sometimes I used to think about it that, why is it that New Kingdom Church will rise to maybe sometimes 130 people, go back to 120 people, go back to 100 people, then go back to 80, go back, you know, and then rise and fall and rise and fall. I had meditated about it at one time or the other. Don't think that we don't think. We think. Praise God. Now, when I went to the United States this time, the Lord answered that question. Because I've been asking questions, I've been thinking about it. I tried to fathom what exactly is the issue, but I couldn't fathom it. But when I get to Dallas, Texas, I went to visit Mike Mudock. When I got there, I saw some things that shook me off my feet. When they took me to the auditorium where they do their service, I saw the place and I used my eyes, because I'm a mathematician, I just used my eyes to calculate all the chairs that are there. I discovered that the chairs there, they are not more than 200. So I simply asked the pastor who was in charge, who was with us. I asked him, I said, how many people are the church member here that attend Sunday service? Sunday service is the major service. And he said to me, we are about 200 people. I said, what? 200 people? And the Lord began to minister to me through that. He said, do you see how this man has impact all over the world? I said, yes. He said, that is what we call church without walls. I have sent him to church without walls. I have not sent him to church with walls. Now, while he was telling me this, while the Holy Ghost was telling me this, I noticed that in the congregation, I noticed that there were tables there. They do school, study. Even on Sunday, he studied. Everybody has pen, paper, and it's already on their table. When you just come, just sit down, you'll be writing. Praise God. But the man has such impact in this generation. Mike, who do not know Mike Mudock in this world? Amen. And they keep writing books on a daily basis. On a daily basis. World renowned books. Now, he's in Dallas, but not all as impactful as his ministry is. In Dallas, only 200 people accepted him. I'm going somewhere. Dallas is full of so many provinces. People is a very big city. But only 200 people believe so much in him that can come to the service to receive his message. It's not to, that you are rejected at one time or the other does not make you a failure. Or that you are not accepted at one time or the other does not make you a failure. That you are not accepted in one area of your life or the other does not mean that you have missed it. Because sometimes you may not be acceptable. Only God understands why you have behaved or you have done things in that certain way. But it does not matter what people think about you. As long as what you are doing is according to the leading of the Holy Ghost, it doesn't matter what men think. Hello? Don't narrow down your life or limit yourself because of what people say about you or because of what people think about you. I mean, your life is not subject to what people think about you or what people say about you. Don't be moved. I see a lot of the children of God, because somebody says something about them, they will be so down. I say, that means this person is so important to your life. Somebody that will speak into your life that will make you to be so down, that means the person is, person is too important in your life. Now, let human being not be important. Let God be important. Replace man with God. When you replace man with God, no matter what man do to you, it will be inconsequential. Are you hearing me? Now, instead of you trying to prove yourself or trying to explain or trying to talk back or trying to say things back to provoke the person as if you want revenge, you don't need it. Sometimes silence is the best answer for a fool. It's an indication that you are more mature than that person that is speaking ill of you. Hello? If somebody is speaking ill of you or talking to you, even in the presence of people, and you are talking back, it's an indication that you are of the same level. But when the person is speaking to you in the presence of people, and you are so quiet, or at the point, or you decide to walk away, it means that you are more mature than the person. If you will follow this teaching that I'm going to teach you, your life will change. I say your life will change. In the name of Jesus. Praise God. So Paul the apostle was rejected by the Jews. Now when Paul the apostle realized that he was rejected by the Jews, he faced the Gentiles. He left the Jews alone. He said, if these Jews people that are my own people, and he loved these people. He loved his people so much. I read the story of Paul the apostle and I pity him, because he was a man that loved his people. Sometimes it's the people you love that will reject you. The people you truly love, they will just reject you. They will put up an attitude. They will put up an act that will give you an act of denial, an act of rejection, an act of refusal, an act of no to you. And you are doing what you are doing to them because you love them. But yet they are rejecting you. It's not something that is new. It started even from the scripture. Adam rejected God. From that beginning, rejection has started. Amen. Cain rejected Abel. From the beginning, rejection has started. Sarah spoke to Abraham. He said, please, it looks like I will not be able to give back. Maybe perhaps God is talking about a child that my maid can give. Of course. In Yoruba language, ento nyeru lo nyeru. What that means is this: the person that owns the slave owns the property, the entire property, including the children of the slave. The slave and their children, they are yours. They are your property. Are you hearing what I'm talking about? So, in the laws of the Jews, that's how it is. So now, the closest maid to Sarah was so close to this maid. And they love each other. Don't think that Sarah just suggested that maid to... Never think that Sarah just wake up in one morning and ask Abraham to go and pick any maid somewhere to impregnate. No. There is a certain level of love that was between Sarah and this maid. I want you to follow me with keen interest this morning. They had so much bond together. She was the closest maid to Sarah. She knew every secret of Sarah. She knew everything about Sarah. When Sarah needs to confide in somebody, she was like a PA to Sarah. She had grown beyond even just an ordinary maid, because she enters into the bedroom in and out. So she knows everything about Sarah. So when Sarah saw that, I can be confident in this maid. I can confide. If I've been confiding in this maid, and this man has been so good to me, and this man has been so she's like an advisory officer to me. Because anytime I speak to her, she talks to me back well. She has never castigated me. She will advise me correctly. I've never heard anything I say to her outside there. this is the right maid for my husband to impregnate. At least when my husband impregnate her, will turn that child to be my child. I'm going somewhere. You read the scripture. Maybe you didn't see the way I'm saying it now. Now suddenly, Abraham agreed to the proposal of Sarah. And he went in with Hagar. And Hagar became pregnant. When she got pregnant and gave birth to a baby boy called Ishmael, they still grew in love. She still grew in love with Sarah, but suddenly things began to fall apart because the expectations of Sarah was no longer met. Sarah thought that this woman would have been able to give. That was the agreement. They had a confidential agreement. Hello. You've been wondering, how did Pastor know this one? The Holy Spirit taught me. Because there are letters, there are things that is between the letters in the Bible that only by the revelation of the Holy Spirit that you can understand. That's why anybody that read the scripture in the logo format, that person is not ready yet to become a true child of God. Because it is the rhema word of God that makes impact in our life. Because the Bible is not a story Bible. That's what makes the difference between those people who read the Bible and like a story Bible. Or like a storybook. Amen. Now, one of the things the Holy Ghost taught me about this scenario was that a guy and Sarah, before Sarah even introduced her to her husband, they have discussed. They have agreed. But it was confidential. That's why you can't see it in the Bible. Only the Holy Spirit can figure it out. Are you hearing me? They discuss. If you give back to this child, it's me that want you to go and sleep. After all, no man can sleep with you now. Because you are my maid. But now, I want my husband to do it. Bring out a child. I agree. You can be doing it forever with my husband. It's not a problem. But there is only one condition. That child that you will give birth to is my own. So that I will not be childless forever. Hello? Is somebody with me here? But at the end of the day, when this woman passed through some pain, she agreed. But when she passed through some pain to deliver Ishmael, she said to herself, how can I pass through this kind of pain? And then I'll go and give the child that I bear in this kind of pain, I'll go and give it to somebody else. God forbid, I'm no longer interested. That agreement is no longer validated. Hello? That agreement is no longer validated. So at the end of the day, she began to misbehave. The Bible says she began to behave in a certain way that Sarah was no longer happy with her, because the same attitude that she put up before now, she has changed. Someone says, if somebody is telling you that you have changed, it's an indication that you are no longer behaving the way you are behaving to that person. True of us. Amen. Praise God. So at the end of the day, I cannot give my child to you. I bought this child in pain. And now, there is a bond between the husband and the woman. Now, Sarah expected the husband to begin to behave in a certain way to the woman because the woman has disrespected her. So, as far as Sarah is concerned, Sarah wanted her husband to equally forget about her and become an enemy to her. Because if this woman has turned out to become my enemy, then this woman equally need to become an enemy to the woman. And Abraham have different philosophy. Abraham has different understanding. Because this woman in question, they have equally entered into each other. So you can't expect him to begin to think the same way that he would naturally have thought when the woman was absolutely a maid. Because right now, as far as Abraham is concerned, that woman is no longer a maid to him anymore. Is somebody with me? Are you following me? Now, Sarah got angry. It got to the peak Sarah called the husband, you must strike back this woman. Now, a guy was rejected. As far as I'm concerned, why should a guy be rejected? I want you to answer that question for me. Because nevertheless, the child that was born into that house. That child was not a bastard. That child was a child of Abraham. Why should they be rejected? Because somebody was born by another woman to the same man. After all, who owns the house? Hello? Women, forgive me. Oh. Some of you, I don't know what is running through your mind right now. But as far as a child is concerned, if it is the real father, he's not a bastard. Hello? If the child is in his father's house, he's not a... But if he's in another person's father's house, then he's a bastard there. That's the meaning of bastard. So now, but because of peace, because the Holy Spirit is the spirit of peace, the Holy Spirit had to appear before Abraham and said to Abraham, honor what your wife has spoken, because I am a God of order. It wasn't that Abraham naturally would do what Sarah asked him to do. That's why sometimes I laugh when some people feel that Pastor Jide should behave in this certain way and Pastor Jide is not behaving that certain way. Because I am not controlled by men. I am controlled by the Holy Ghost. The ways of God are far away from your ways. So I am not here to move by your ways or to do things the way you want me to do things. I am here to do things the way God wants me to do it. So if the Holy Ghost spoke to me, son, this is what you should do. If one man is telling me, son, friend or brother or pastor, this is what you should do. Which one do I follow now? Uh-huh. Amen. Oh. Praise God. So if somebody will not get offended and leave the church because of that, that's the problem of that person. I'm not the one that's going to lose. Because the work of God will continue. We have seen people come here, they have left. The church is still constant. It's still moving forward. Hello? The church cannot go down because the church is ordained of God. If we do not do things the way you want us to do it, if you get angry because of that, you are having a problem with God, not with me. Amen. Or if you reject what God asked me to do, well, that's your own problem. As long as it is God who asks us to do it, we do it the way God wants us to do it. Amen. Is somebody happy with me here? You will not be rejected. I say 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 you will not be rejected. In the name of Jesus. God spoke to Abraham. So Abraham did not honor the words of his wife. He honored the word of God. Did you read that scripture very well? He honored God, not his wife. Because God is a God of order. God does want peace. Anything that will cause division in his house, in the church, God does not put hand in it. Whether you are right or wrong, it doesn't matter. It's inconsequential. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Whether you are right or you are wrong, it doesn't matter. As long as your right is going to affect the unity of the body of Christ, that your right is already wrong before God. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Is somebody excited in the house today? Amen. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So, a guy and the son, Ishmael, was rejected. God said, let them go. You know, Abraham gave them the little he can give to them, and they went away. That is what has caused us the problem of Boko Haram and their cohort, ISIS, or whatever. That has caused us forever, and God blessed them. The Bible says, and God blessed Ishmael and his mother, God bless them. And that their generation will never be wiped away from the earth. So that's why, you see, I believe in the prophecy of the Bible. You cannot pray Boko Haram out. You can't pray them into extinction. You can only pray them into disempowerment. Is somebody with me here? Because the power, God has empowered us to disarm. God has empowered us to pull down. But there are some things based on the prophecy of God himself we cannot extinct by prayer. If you are praying, you are an ignoramus. Hello? The Bible says if you pray amidst, your prayer will not be granted. Is that not so? That means that most of the time we pray amidst. And when we pray amidst, our prayers are not granted. You pray Boko Haram into extinction. Did you know how long Boko Haram has been in existence? They have not been powerful for a long time until this government that is wrapping up now. Are you hearing what I'm saying? And then they became so powerful. So many of us don't even know that there's anything called Boko Haram. But they have been in existence. Since how long in this country? If you understand the history. Are you hearing me? So you cannot pray them into extinction. A day come, if the church disobey God, if they don't do what they ought to do, Boko Haram will come as a thorn in their flesh. That is the standard of the biblical prophecy. There is nothing you can do about it. You can only pray them in. You can only disarm them. Disarm their weapon. Disarm their gadget. They will not have power over you. Because God has empowered you as the generation of Isaac. It's good to understand the Bible. Because if you don't, I don't pray anyhow. I don't pray. I ask my wife. Many times when my wife is pray. She said, Pastor, you are not praying. I said, leave me alone. It's not a time to pray. This is a time to meditate. Two of us. I'm a practical preacher. I don't pray anyhow. So you must tell me why I want to pray, and you must relate it to the scripture for me. The reason why I want to pray that way, because if I... Amen. I don't want to waste my time praying, and then my energy will be a waste. I don't have that energy all enough. The small energy I have, let me preserve it for something that is real. Amen. That's why I don't just pray. If you see me leave prayer on the altar, it's on point. There's something I'm praying about. There's a reason why I'm praying that way. It's on point. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. So, Paul the Apostle, as the greatest apostle that ever lived, was rejected by the Jews. Then he had to go to a place where they accepted him. I've said, when I was talking about Mama, I said, if you don't accept her very well now, you know, you are being celebrated where you are accepted. And wherever you are celebrated and accepted, your will will be up. Hello? I'm preaching the message there. Hello. Message is being preached there, three of us. By the time we keep preaching this message, something will happen. By fire, by force, something will happen. Amen. Praise God. Rejection is such a common and necessary encounter on your way to success. Never pray yourself out of an encounter with rejection. Sometimes rejection can be very painful. Why? Because rejection at one time or the other brings about a certain level of loss. Three of us. If your business proposal is rejected, you have lost some certain amount of money. If your sales is rejected, you have lost a certain amount of profits. If your marriage proposal is rejected, you have just lost somebody and you have lost time. Because you have built your life with that person at a particular point in time, you are so close that you feel that this thing can work, and suddenly, only to be rejected. that it cannot work. How will you feel? Because you will now begin to think, how do I start again? You want to go and start from... I mean, it's very painful because you have lost time. You have lost opportunities. It is somebody with me. Because at that period where you are engaged or you are in that relationship, some other prospectors are coming, but yet you cannot see them because you are already inside another one. Suddenly, you are rejected. How will you feel? Loss of time and loss of opportunity. So there is no rejection that does not come with a certain level of loss. Or even me as a pastor here, some certain things we do, which is that we are led by the Holy Ghost to do it, and it does not go well with one particular person. It begins to castigate. Before you know it, maybe some people even left because of prognosing and gossiping. I'm saying, it has caused you a loss because to gather is not easy. Do you understand? So when you lose people, even when they misbehave, you are not happy because you love their soul. You love them deeply from your heart. So when they even go, even though they have done wrong, you don't want to count it against them the most as a pastor. I'm talking about as a shepherd now. And then you want them to come back. You want to do all you can to make them come back. But if you have done all you can for them to come back, if they don't come back, what can you do? You leave them. Because Paul the apostle himself was rejected by the Jews. At a point, because of his love for them, he kept pressing and pressing. But at a point, he discovered that even though he was pressing, there was really nothing he could do for them to accept him. So he had to turn to the people, the Gentiles, that were willing to accept him. Even Jesus said that. Jesus himself said that. I'm going to come to that. In the book of Luke, Jesus was saying something to his disciples. He said, there are places you'll be rejected and there are places you'll be accepted. He said, dwell more in the places that you are accepted. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Jephthah was rejected by his own brothers. Our brothers. They told him to his face, you are a son of a prostitute in his father's house. How can your younger ones face you like this and tell you you are a son of, you are not even a girl. Oh, if you are a girl, we'll say, okay, they can say something because the girl will still go out there and have another surname or last name. But you see, a boy who is the firstborn of the family, their mother was not married when he was giving battle. As far as Yoruba culture is concerned, their mother of these people that were talking to Jephthah was not even supposed to be able to call Jephthah by name. Because in our own tradition, in Yoruba language, you can't call those people that has been born before you came into that home, you can't call them by name. Even though it has fizzled away by civilization. But that's our culture. So, ideally speaking, Jephthah was supposed to be respected even by their mother. Now, the same Jephthah, they simply came to him and said, you are a son of a prostitute. We don't need you in our father's house. Because lest you come and share out of... And you know, in the land of Jews, the firstborn, the first maleborn, is usually the one that take the entire inheritance of their father. So it's now left to him to be able to share it appropriately. And that was what MKO practiced. He didn't share no will. All the will was given to Kola Abiola, his first son. It is at the discretion of Kola Abiola that he had to give to whoever he wants to give anything to. Because he is the firstborn. So he uses the ideology of the Jewish nation. It was a Jewish ideology. Amen. So first male born at the strength of their father. Even though when my own father died, there was nothing to hear it. And the Bible says, a good man or a righteous man leaveth inheritance for his children. I told myself, I'm not blaming him. He has made some mistakes in his life. Not blame. That's why I recognize all the mistakes my father made, and I don't want to make those mistakes in my own life. as the Lord liveth, I will leave inheritance to my children.
Amen.
God forbid that I will die without leaving inheritance for my children. God forbid. Because I will not fulfill the scripture that says a righteous man liveth inheritance for his children. Don't spend everything you have. Plan for your future. Plan for the future of your children. Don't eat everything. Use all your hand, 10 hands to eat. You are eating. Chop. Can't you plan for your future? Amen. Somebody still happy with me? Hallelujah. Praise God. Most times, rejection can be very painful. It can be teardrops. I wrote here. It can be a confusion. It can bring about a suicidal thought. Many people, especially in the civilized nation, they have died of rejection. Pastor Sam Adeyemi in Lagos of Desta, many years ago, he kept praying and fasting, wanted to fast to death because he needed an American visa. He went the first time, they rejected him. Second time, they rejected him. Third time, they rejected him. Fourth time, they rejected him. I can't know how many times, maybe 7 times. But at the 7 times, according to him, which is the number of perfection, this time around, he shall be perfected. So he went to the mountain and fasted like he wanted to die. Became so skinny. As a matter of fact, that skinny body that he took there is enough to make them reject him. This one, he's hungry. When he gets to America, he won't come back again. You are fasting. Who knows whether we are fasting? Americans does not care whether you fast. It's lack of understanding. My people perish for lack of knowledge. Fast yourself because you want to go and receive visa. Gone are the days that people like us can think like that. I can never fast for some certain things. I can't fast for money. I can't fast. There are things, you know, there are things we do that we don't even know that we're actually doing wrong. And we believe so much in it. And that we waste our time in it. And we waste our effort in it. You want to marry fasting? You want to... You fast against the power of the kingdom of darkness. When you sense it. To kill all demonic powers that want to subdue and suppress you. You are not fasting because you want to go and get something. Everything that pertains to life and godliness have been given to you. Just claim it by the scripture. But when you sense the hand of the evil one, you can fast to cut off their evil hands. But not you are fasting, you want to go and collect visa, you fast. You want to go and collect pure water, you fast. Now you kill Jesus. Even the Jews that killed Jesus, they don't fast like that. And their sins have been forgiven. Praise God. It may be funny, but it's true. So he fasted and prayed. When he appeared at the American embassy, they denied him. When they denied him this time, he was full of sorrow for all the deniers. But this last denier, he returned and he was laughing. When he got out of the embassy, he was just laughing. This one cannot be the devil anymore. I have bind the devil enough. The devil has no capacity to stop me. This one is God. Lord, what are you saying? God said, what I am saying is that come and preach on the pulpit. Until only God knows how his life would have been if he had gone to that America. He would have been among the people that are working $8 per hour. Do you know how wealthy this man is right now? Do you know how outstanding he is right now? Do you know that they will beg him to come to the United States of America today? If you are rejected, find out why you are rejected. Don't be angry because you are rejected. Don't be too quick to anger. You know, I don't blame you because you don't understand. Sometimes I get angry because of rejection. I was just coming into the U.S. I came back the day before yesterday. And in London, I got a call. As I switched on my phone, I got a call. Lo and behold, it was a call from one of my sons. one Dr. Dami, who is one of my sons. So when I switched off my MTN at Heathrow Airport, and then suddenly after 5 minutes, my phone rang. It was a UK number. I don't even know the number. So I picked it. Lo and behold, it was him. And he said, I'm the one calling from UK. I said, that is fantastic. As I'm talking to you right now, I am in Heathrow Airport. He said, what? He said, I want to see you right now. He said, I'm coming right away. Tell me where you are. I said, Terminal 5, this and that. I said, okay, I'm on my way. I tried to come out of that place. The security people escorted me out. When I got to the place where I need to check in through the immigration people look at my passport. They said, what do you want to go out to do? When I said, I have somebody waiting for me outside. I said, okay, that's good. I said, I'm not going out of the airport. I'm just going to the arrival to meet with the person. I said, okay, in such things, because you don't have a UK visa, we can give you a 24-hour visa by our own initiative. But suddenly, he collected my passport and he opened my passport, only to see that I have been rejected twice in UK visa. I have been rejected, not once even, two times. When he saw it, when she saw it, she said, I'm sorry, you've been rejected in the United Kingdom embassy? I said, yes. She doesn't even want to know the reason. I said, okay, you can help me. You can help me out. You can give me that 24 hours visa. I know you can do it. She said, oh, yeah, well, I will try. I can do it, but we operate by principles and procedures here. Okay, give me some few minutes. They gave me a paper that they were going to check me up. I was angry. I was mad. When I look at the person, you can be detained, you can be the mark, you can be detained, you can be searched, you can be this, you can be that. I say, I will send, in my heart of mine, I say, I will send these people, they didn't know me. I say, I will send the devil to slap them. In my heart, I couldn't say that, but I said, I will send the devil to slap this idiot here. Can you imagine them rejecting me here? And then not only that they are rejecting me, they gave me paper in my hand. I was so angry that one man had to interpret it to me because I saw their mark, you can be searched, you can be put into something to check you very well, you can be detained. That is even what makes me angry most. Detained for what? And they mark, they check the box of you can be detained. I say, I can be detained. It is not enough that you rejected me, you want to detain me, then I will send not God this time, the devil. You know, the devil is in my territory. I can equally send him on errand. Oh, these people didn't understand. Do you know that the devil is in my territory? I can send the devil. Because if I send God, God is too slow to anger. There are some things you don't need to send God. God said, command ye me, fine. You can command God to do some things. But there are things that you command God, God will be slow to, because it's a slow to anger personality. The devil likes to torture people. So send the devil, let it be quick. The torture of the devil is so quick. So I thought in my heart that I'm going to send the devil to these people. Because I was angry. Now it dawned on me that the two rejections they gave to me in UK embassy, I better rather do something fast to go and get their visa. Because if I don't go back to get their visa, the trauma of that rejection will still be pursuing me all around the places. I'm telling you, it brings about loss to be rejected. Just for me to be able to get entrance into that place, I lost that opportunity. If not that God now helped me with wisdom, I sent someone who can assess that place to go out there and meet the man for me. The person now went on my behalf. Can you imagine? Some pounds sterling came into my pocket through that visitation. Can you imagine what the devil want to do to me? Want to deny me of those pounds? What a loss. What a loss that rejection can bring. What a loss that rejection can bring to people. I would have missed that pound sterling. Do you know how much pound sterling? When I got to Nigeria, I asked somebody, how much is pound sterling now? He said about 280. I said, glory be to God. This money, I need it right now in this country. And he vaguely encouraged me that to even be able to have that contact again, because I had to call the person when I got the money to tell the person, oh, thank you. He said, and the person began to tell me so many years ago when he came, he was suffering, things were not working. And I told him some few things. It encourages my prophetic office. Because for one whole year, he was coming to me and it looks like what you are saying, Pastor Jide, I don't see it happening. It was like, Pastor, everything you have spoken, I love them, but I don't know. My life is completely opposite. This is what he said to me with his own mouth. He said, my life is completely opposite. I don't know how it will come to pass. But he told me everything that I have spoken into his life has come to pass. And listen to what he said again. He said, for the past 3 days, God has been speaking to me to call you and that I should sow this seed into your life. I don't know why it is today I decided to call you when you are in Itro. But however, God has spoken to me equally about your ministry and has spoken to me that your ministry is a worldwide ministry and that there is going to be churches all over the world. And God has said to me that I should sponsor 8 nations where you will be planting churches. God has spoken to me. He said, don't worry, Pastor Jide. Money will not be your ministry problem. He said, right now, the money I'm sending to you now is my first encounter money that came into my, it's like a first fruit. You hear what I'm talking about? It's like first fruit. I now live in the most expensive place in London. Oyibo people carry me in a limousine all around the city of London. Pastor Jide, I want you to come and visit me. Don't you see that the devil is an idiot? Because right now, I must get that UK visa. By fire, by force. How can I have so much blessing waiting for me in UK? So many people are waiting for this man that is standing here in the UK. They are waiting for me to gain entrance there. The devil is an idiot. Any devil that is bringing rejection into your life, I curse that devil to the roots. In the name of Jesus. Whatever entrance that God has opened the gate to you and the devil wants to shut the gate against you, I command the devil to die for your sake and I command this gate to open in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Rejection comes with a degree of loss. That's why now we must begin to do some certain things that will help us against any incidents of rejection. You can actually reduce the rate of rejection in your life if you put up a certain way of life. There are some certain way of life that God expected us to take, to carry ourselves. It will help us against rejection. Hallelujah. Death has no power against his rejection. There are some certain rejection, even though Jesus lives inside of you and is the hope of your glory, those rejection, you have no power against them. They will come. But there are some certain rejection that you can stand against that are not expected or permitted to come to you. When I was rejected the last time in the United Kingdom Embassy, I was trying to find out what was happening. I initially wanted to take them to court. I contacted an immigration lawyer who was willing to. I've even paid it. I think Brother Tai will know knows what I'm talking about. But later, we decided I decided not to go to court. They can't win me if I go to court because I'm a traveler. So they will tell me, if they are telling me the reason why they rejected me was that they are not sure that I will return, they are stupid. Because I have gone to America for more than 20 times. More than 20 times I've been in America. And I've come back. I didn't stay there. So what assurance can you now? How can you prove it in the court that I will go to UK there and I won't come back? Don't you see that is stupidity? Amen. Amen. May they not be stupid because I'm speaking from the altar. So that they can give me the visa. Because if they are stupid again, they may reject me again. May they not be stupid in Jesus' name. Amen. So that they can give me the visa next time I apply. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. You know, some pastors cannot preach this message I'm preaching now. They make everything look like they have never been rejected. I'm going to lie. 99% of their lifestyle is rejection. Be real with what you're doing. I've been rejected, though, in so many things. But today, there are some places we have been rejected yesterday. They are begging us to come today. Amen. You will be successful. Amen. I say you will be successful. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, there is a man, you know, how many of you know Michael Jordan? Michael Jordan was a man who had applied into places for as a basketballer, and they have rejected him several times. But suddenly, they accepted him somewhere. And he became the greatest basketballer in his time. Now, the days of his rejection notwithstanding, he was a successful basketballer. You can't speak about the history of of basketball in this world and not mention the name of Michael Jordan. It doesn't matter how many times you've been rejected. Those who have rejected you, they will return to beg you. That amen is too paralyzed. That amen is too paralyzed. I said to myself, how many people have rejected me in this life? Me, I am a young man of 41. I'm about to enter 41. Not even up to 41 yet. Still a small boy. And now, in my 41-year-old of life experience, I've experienced some things that some people that are 70 years have not experienced in life. I lost my father when I got admission into university. 1994. The same time that my father died, my admission letter arrived by post. Not now that everybody go to look for admission. Legacy's bends, hand bends, feet bends, to be able to get admission. In those days, they would post it to you. Nobody is looking. We receive admission by posting. I don't know whether it's happening again in these days. Nigeria is suddenly becoming issues. Every issues of this nation, I wrap it up. The ones that are not palatable, that is not of God, I wrap them up right now as I speak, and I throw them into a trash of fire. The Lord will repair this nation again. There are things that are not happening nowadays that are happening now. You'll be wondering, why is it like that? Hallelujah. Praise God. I say, praise God. Hallelujah. Somebody is here. You always think about some certain rejection of your life. I'm just hearing it right now. You're a woman. You always think about your rejections, the experiences of life that you have gone through. God said, I should tell you that the days of rejections are over. If you receive it as I'm speaking right now, the anointing to make it happen in your life is released. I said, the days of your rejections are over. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Quickly, let me look at how do we handle rejection. How do we handle rejection? Because you need to begin to have the mentality of seeing rejection as a step towards your success. Somebody rejects you, shout hallelujah. There is a better person that is coming for me. Me? When I was young and I want to marry, if you reject me, that is your palaver. Hey, you reject me, I go for a better person. I'm speaking on the altar of God. You reject me, if you reject me, no wala na. That means that there's a better person for me. Are you hearing what I'm talking about? Rejoice when somebody rejects you. A guy comes to you and rejects you, that means that guy is not worth you. Hello? Any guy that comes to a New Kingdom Church ladies and the guy messed up, just know that guy is not worth it. He's not worth it. That guy is not, he's not worth you. He's not worth your value. You are too valuable than that guy. Your mentality matters in life. Don't be, you come and cry because one man said, I'm no longer doing. If he's no longer doing, let him go to hell. There is somebody that is going to do, and that person is going to be greater than that person. Hello? Am I speaking to some people here? What am I doing? If you carry your sins, your product to places where you want them to buy it and accept you, if they refuse, tell them that you have a better place that will accept your proposal. There's a better sales waiting for me somewhere else. Are you hearing me? Haven't you heard about Kennedy, one of the ex-president of the United States of America? How many times did he contest? He contested for so many times. At the end of the day, he became the president. And he was one of the most renowned presidents in the United States of America that has performed well. I praise you, oh Lord. I praise you, I praise you, oh in the name of Jesus. I'm not bothered about nobody. I don't like nobody. I love this nation more than any individual. Whoever will be, people have viewed me on TV with this message I'm preaching. Anybody that win truly of God and of men shall mount the throne of presidency in this nation. And I dispatch angelic hosts and host of heavens to make it happen in the name of Jesus. Any chaotic arrangement in this nation, I bind that spirit in the name of Jesus. And anyone involved in any chaotic arrangement in this nation, the earth will open up and swallow them up in the name of Jesus. I speak as a prophet unto nations. The born you will come and ask me. Hallelujah. If I will not send the devil to you. Olorun to that one. Okay. Okay. Pastor Jide will pray for you. If the person If the marriage, you people will do well in terms of money, I may just see the money. I say, ah, this marriage will be very good. Because I've seen money. I'm speaking to you the truth. Many people are prayed for and they said the marriage is good. One sister came to me in Philadelphia and said, I prayed about this, my husband, and now this thing is not working. I laugh. I say it's not about prayer. If you pray, if 20 pastors pray for you and 20 of them say it's good, first check. Because being good is different from the character. Character is different from capacity. God can show a prophet the capacity level. He may not show the prophet the character level. That God says that is good does not mean that that good is good enough. If you cannot develop your character, it may not work. Is somebody with me here? The Bible says only the truth to make free. So many marriages are spoken of by God, yet they are not working because they have refused to develop themselves. Develop yourself. Some women, they have the character of when they get married, that is the end. After all, who am I dressing for now? When you are dressing to look for men when you are single. Now you are married, you are no longer dressing. You become a woman in the house. And you want the man not to see another person that has shaped the way you had shaped when you were single. Do you really want me to say the truth here? I told somebody, I said, do you know how to know that somebody is beautiful? Man, I'm teaching you something here. A woman is beautiful when the woman has dropped 2-3 episodes. If the woman dropped 3 episodes and the woman is still looking spirit, then you can say, yes, indeed, this man is beautiful. But when the woman dropped 2-3, and the woman, now all the shape now became shapeless. You now see contour everywhere. The man will begin to look at the woman and say, ah, but this is not the woman I married. The Rachel I married 2003 is not the same Rachel in 2015. Oh God. And the man will begin to have concerns. I'm talking the truth. Ask her now. When she delivered David, I just saw this tummy very. The shape now became shapeless. Tummy now big like. I said, we have to do something about this. Your tummy. We have to. Me, I talk. I ask her, I talk. Oh, if I don't like something, I tell her right there. I am a talking man. If you don't talk, that's your problem. Things will just be going bad. And you can quarrel, fight, it doesn't matter. But you have talked the truth. Talk the truth. And shame the devil. And she too normally talk the truth. So we are the same. 4 cut 2 is divisible. 3 of us is divisible. Whatever she doesn't like me, she tells me. Sometimes she looked at me to say, you two, you are beginning to have tummy. I quickly begin to work on my tummy. Hello? Everything is not spiritual. God will not come and do some certain thing for you. If you need to gym. If you need to be spotless. If you need to dress well, be dressed. God will not come from heaven and come and put clothes in your body. God does not do that one for anybody. I said to myself, I need to go get something, solution to this thing. I asked about 2-3 persons, and they gave me one solution. Go get gedu for your wife. They call it gedu. I took myself from my house for me to go to the market by myself. You know what it means? It's a serious matter. I went and got the gedu by myself. I went to the market and bought the gedu by my own self. I know, like, tell me. The woman must be fit so that things can be. God said he made everything pleasurable. I'm not one of those persons that is spiritual. I'm not going to heaven. I'm already in heaven here. Let me enjoy my life here before we get to heaven. can't be suffering here and then be waiting for one heaven that may not come. We don't know when it will come. You may even live till 90 and still heaven didn't come. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. It's at hand. Yes, it's at hand. As you are growing old, the kingdom of heaven is every is at hand. That's the meaning. Hello. Do you people want me to tell you the truth? Develop yourself. Develop yourself mentally. Develop yourself physically. Don't be stagnated. I say because I'm married. I'm married. The woman say I'm married. Cut off everywhere. No. One person saw me that knows me while I was in secondary school. He said, apart from the fact that you're a little bit taller than when we were in secondary school, your face, everything just remains the same. I said, how you not going to remain the same? I said, check me out in the next 40 years, I'll still be like this. And if my hair wants to be white, I will darken it. Yes, so. God himself said, dress. He spoke to Adam. He said, dress this garden. Dress it. Don't just wash the garden. I'm the one that put you in this garden and I've placed you in this garden the way this garden is. But you need to dress it. I am not going to dress it for you. You need to dress it yourself. What it means is you need self-development. Academic self-development, mental self-development, spiritual self-development, physical self-development. You need to develop yourself. Things that you know you will eat that will give you health challenge. Why do you still eat it? Will you die if you don't eat those things? Why can't you check your own body system and eat what goes with your body? Are you hearing me? I don't know. I feel like teaching, telling you reasons. I don't know why God is taking me this lane. Maybe on Thursday I'll tell you how to handle rejection because time has passed. If you are being rejected and your husband is complaining about some contour in your body, you better do something. If you don't know what to do, call your husband, sit down and say, okay, you are the one that is complaining about this contour. They were not there before. You were one of the people that panabit this contour to come out. Now, tell me a way out of the contour. Yes, so you are permitted. You can sit him down and tell him, look, whatever you need to do, I'm ready. I want to do it now. I want to sacrifice. Let's go and do it. So that your marriage can work. It's not every man that is so spiritual like that, oh. Don't be deceived by spirituality, oh. Too many people that are... Don't be deceived. Whatever you notice your spouse is complaining about, work on it. If you don't know how, call him. You are the one complaining about this thing. How do we solve it? Hello? The character you don't want in your husband or you don't want in your wife, if you see it in the person you are courting and you have complained about it and they cannot stop, it is not when you marry that the person will stop. As a matter of fact, change is the most difficult thing for an adult. Somebody who has been wired in a certain way till he grows up to 30 years and you now suddenly want the person to change, I have discovered by experience. You know, some wisdom comes by experience. This will not be by spirituality. By experience, I have discovered that change is the most difficult thing. When I just got married, thank God my wife is here now. There are some things I don't like. I said, no, this thing, I don't want it. You, what kind of woman are you? I scream at every two of us. But by experience, I call it that, discovered that this change is not achievable like this. I thought the change would be digging very fast. As I scream, you this woman. When I say you this woman, she knows that. And then I say, you this woman. I say, so we quarrel. We disagree to agree. Any person that tells you that they don't quarrel, check out the person that they have the worst situation in their house. They are just pretenders. Even Jesus almost quarreled with God by saying that if you can make this cup pass over me. Naturally speaking, Jesus didn't want to go ahead. But he later looked at it that is in the best interest of my life.
Praise God, viewers. I'm excited because I know that you are tremendously blessed by that telecast. I want to specially invite you to our special Holy Ghost anointing service on Sunday, 9 a.m. at New Kingdom Church, Crane Plaza, first floor, plot 742, adjacent Shaba Filling Station, Wuye, Abuja. And I want to encourage you because I will be specially waiting to have a handshake with you. And I know you will be healed, you will receive your miracles, you will receive your blessings, and above all, you will be lifted and elevated. I want to assure you that it is a place to be, a place where you will reign as king in God's kingdom. God bless you. If you have not given your life to Jesus and you are watching me now, I want to let you know that sinners have no place in God's kingdom. Pray this simple prayer with me. Lord Jesus, have mercy upon me. Forgive me my sins. Thank you for saving me in Jesus' name. If you have prayed that prayer, there are numbers on the screen. Just call on us and we will attend to you. Or if you desire to be counseled, you can equally call that number that appears on the screen. God bless you as you do so in Jesus' name. I remain your faithful servant, Pastor Jide Ogunsakin. Bye for now. God bless you.
Any demonic group that is working against your destiny, today, by the fire of this altar, I command it to disappear.